Very good afternoon to all. The discussion title of our discussion will remain, or you can say that we will focus on the identity in peer review. So every basically who is involved with the research, they are aware about the peer review process in research. So there are many things being a researcher, we know about the peer review, and many things basically remains hide that we are not aware about all those things. So we will try to bring out those points in this particular discussion, so that the researcher basically becomes aware about all the peer review process. So being an editor and publisher, I have some experiences, and along with me, Professor Poonam Tandon from Lucknow University, and Professor Adesh Sharma from Dairy Research Institute, and Dr. Mamta Agarwal from the Mumbai University. So before I go into the brief detail of the panelist, I would like to share some points about to the Chitkara University publications and to what we are doing, and at what stage basically right now we are. So being a publisher, we are publishing 9 different journals in different disciplines since 2013. And we basically had submitted our journal for this corpus and got the good feedback, but still only one management journal is under a review process more than 1.5 years. And getting positive feedback from others. So we had learned many number of the things, and myself, Dr. Sushil Kumar, basically taking care of all these things. And everybody knows that like in foreign countries, there is a university press. So at the same pattern, we had also moving on that path and developed and created our own university press. So here, in Chitkara University, we take care of all these things. And right now, actually, we have collaborated with the UNESCO project where they are giving us technology. And we are a platinum open access journal. That means we are not taking any article processing charge. And we are publishing all articles with the Creative Commons license. Creative Commons license means that many times, being a researcher, you are aware that you require some content of your research article. And that time, what happens? You ask to the editor or publisher to take that figure or content of your own article. But in Creative Commons license, there is no requirement to ask the editor or publisher. You are free to use your own content. So here, in this panel discussion, I want to brief some highlight about to the Professor Adesh Kumar Sharma, and let me give the opportunity to read something more about to him and contribution to the dairy research. So Professor Adesh Kumar Sharma belongs to the Agriculture Research Services under Indian Council of Agriculture Research. Purpose is what to involve the panelists from different domain and research area. Professor Adesh Kumar Sharma actually involved into the dairy research, but he is a computer science expert and involved into the machine learning and many more advanced things related to the computer science. So he is principal scientist of computer application in agriculture in the division of dairy economics, statistics and management at the ICR National Dairy Research Institute, deemed to be University of Karnal. He has obtained a PhD degree from Thapar Institute of Engineering and Technology, Patiala. He has about 35 years of professional experience in the field of computing and computer center management and administration. And there are many more things that I can read, but I believe that it will be better if I am just giving 5 to 7 minutes to each panelist to say something about their contribution, because it will be far better if I will read that will be not much effective. So Professor Adesh Sharma, sir, would you like to say something about your achievement and contribution into the dairy research and how you are involved into the peer review process? So it will be better for the audience. Sir.
At the onset, first I say good afternoon to everyone, especially the panelists and the audience as well. And I would like to share the recent experiences that we all have. The quality of published scientific literature in general bears direct impact on the global society. And this is best demonstrated during the COVID-19 pandemic that has changed our life tremendously throughout the globe, not only restricted to area. So that is the effectiveness of experts or government's recommendations, guidelines framed on the basis of authentic published reports of various scientific trials of the vaccines and other related issues have proved to be of utmost importance for all of us, okay? And it is important for safeguarding the human lives against the pandemic as well, as other similar diseases. Hence, the peer reviewing of scientific publications is a great responsibility of the scientific society. So peer reviewing is a very serious and important and essential part of any kind of scientific publications. As regards my experience and DRI involvement in publications and their peer reviewing, I would like to share. I have very interesting and rich experiences because I started my career way back in 1988, and we have seen the tremendous change that the computer science field has undergone. And in the era of this pandemic, we have greatly, witnessed the importance of IT. I think in our country, if IT was not there, so many things could have come to standstill. You can very well understand the losses that we have all incurred due to this pandemic. And if IT is not there in place, I think it would have been very disastrous for all of us. And as far as IT is concerned, I still remember the remarks of one editor-in-chief of a journal. Maybe 20 years back, he said, because some reviewers gave some adverse remarks about some work that we have submitted for reviewing and possible publication in the journal. So he said that such type of works are liked by the developing country governments like that. He made some absurd remarks, because in this identity is also an issue. And maybe we were taken into a different perspective by the international people. But that editor-in-chief said that as far as IT is concerned, India is a developed country. Okay, so that is, I still remember the encouraging remarks of that editor-in-chief. He encouraged, and we could not publish, of course, in that journal. But later, you will wonder to know that I have become reviewer of that journal now. Okay, it is a very reputed journal. So this is a refinement process, and peer reviewing is really very important. As far as my PhD work was concerned, you see, after 2.5 years, that paper was returned, and I was about to close my work, and they said, the whole experiment needs to be revised. But the comments were really important and good for the improvement of my work. So I took very painful job. Within a week or so, I had to do it. And I did it. But it greatly helped me to improve and enhance the quality of the work. So reviewers have, across the world, people are there to help you publish your work in a good way. So quality is utmost important, and the concept and this responsibility of and importance of this peer reviewing is really very essential. And other kind of malpractices in terms of identity. If you come across me, I don't like your work, I don't like you, or I don't like your institution, like that. So I think we should come out of this, and we should concentrate only on the content of the work, and we should be very honest in reviewing our work. Then the quality, our utmost importance is the quality of the work, authenticity of the work, so that anybody can refer to it, reproduce it in their labs, and we should be generously sharing all our work to the rest of the world. I think this is my experience, but if we go to micro level, many things can be shared and discussed. That depends. So I stop here and over to Dr. Sushil.
Thank you, sir. And nice to know about your journey into the research domain. And now I come to the Madam Professor Poonam Tandon, that I know Madam through Facebook and her activity, different activity as a DSW of the Lucknow University, and research activities and her popularity among the research scholars. And her efforts into the direction of the academics, whether that is in the, during the pandemic when the university had started videos on YouTube channel and developing the that kind of platform. So I am just aware about all these things from the social media. So now, this is I'm not hesitate to say among the audience that this is first time when I'm interacting directly with Professor Poonam Tandon. So over to you, ma'am, and just let us know about your journey, more about to the your visits in foreign countries, and idea about to the research and peer review, how basically you see and the researcher. So something about to your lab and your journey.
Thank you very much for asking me to join this interesting discussion on the peer review. Okay, and it is really very nice to interact with you directly. We know each other from social media, and I find you very, very active and in the communication, especially the scientific communication. And you are using all possible modes of scientific communication and spread it amongst the everyone. So that is what I admire about you. It's great. And if you talk about the research and peer review, see, I am also the member of editorial board of a couple of journals, very prestigious journals having impact factor more than 3 or 4 or so. And I have reviewed maybe in last 5 years more than 150, or I don't remember. There is a site which gives you the number of reviews. What is the name? Could you please remind me? Pavlon. The Pavlon gives detail about your reviews if you registered it. It is, I think, more than 140 or maybe 160. I don't remember it exactly. So I am also like doing this review extensively. Okay. I think the role of review in publication is very, very important. It is not only for the language, but also for the scientific content. If the reviewer is from the same field, okay, he can give you many more ideas to take your research to the next level. Okay, and if you can follow some of the reviewer is doing very nicely, the review is done very nicely or extensively, then he or she will give you very good ideas to take your work to the next level, and that is very, very like important in that area. Like when I started as a PhD student and we used to write papers, sometime our supervisors were very, very busy. You know, it is very common. Supervisors are very, very busy, and we lack some points in our publication. And we used to, the reviewer was very, very important. Sometime she was playing the role of our supervisor also for a PhD student, and reading through whole the paper, giving you very important suggestions, especially for a PhD student. Okay. and that give us chance to improve our work also. Okay, now the question is, now a lot of discussion is going on, which is a recent field, that a blind review. Okay, sometimes we get a paper from a very renowned person, okay, and we are also influenced by the name. We don't, sometimes we think, okay, this paper is from a very renowned group, it will be good. So rather than doing serious review or looking to the paper critically, sometimes we pass this paper like this. For example, I can give you some of the examples. I met a postdoc fellow in US, and he was working in NPL before joining the US. And he said, I communicated my paper in very ACS journal, very good journals, when I was a PhD student in NPL, and those papers were not published. When I went to US, I added the name of that university, and the same paper was published in the very good journals. I think you all agree with this. And if you have an author from abroad or from a very outstanding group, the same. So the he or researcher is doing very good work. Okay. So these are some of the lacuna of the review. Okay. And see, we all are influenced by all these things. So I think the new concept which is coming up, that is a blind review. Blind review can be at two ends. First is, do not disclose the name of author. Okay, that is one thing. Just review the paper on the basis of its quality. Second is, the blind review is, do not even disclose the name of the, generally the name of. If the review can be done without disclosing the name of author or the affiliation of the author or country of the author, I think that will be more fair. Or fairer in comparison to the way review process is going on right now for different journals. If you see ACS journal or any Scopus or Web of Science journal, all the journals, when you receive the paper, you know the name of author, you know the affiliation. Sometimes there are the groups which are like competitive. The work, if you are doing some work, other group is doing some work in that area, and there is some type of competition also. Okay, and that can also affect the reviewing process. So I think now we should move towards the blind review. That is what I feel to be more fairer. And it can also give a chance to the younger ones or the researchers who are not very much established in the field. And they will get a fair chance to publish good papers. See, anyone in the research is not only for those who are established in the field. Sometimes the person who is very young or entering in the field, he can have very new or innovative idea, and he would have done very nice work. Okay, so if we have an unbiased attitude of blind review, I think the quality of review will improve, and we will have good papers, not only from the papers, from the good groups. So that is two things. I will say this much, and maybe if other persons will give their views, and then I can make some more comments on this. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. And now we are moving towards Dr. Mamta Agarwal, ma'am, that belongs from the Department of Physics, Mumbai University, and working as a scientist in DST projects. She is also involved in many more activities and providing many things to the graduate and postgraduate students, and making awareness about to the research and science activities to the students, especially for UG and PG students, and organizing many events. So it would be better, Dr. Mamta Agarwal, if you will say your research experience as well as the general things that you are doing for the society.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Sushi, for inviting me for this interesting topic of discussion, that is identity of peer review. Very good morning to all the esteemed panelists and the audience present here. This is a very, very relevant topic for a researcher. And in fact, it is a huge responsibility on a publisher when they have to choose a reviewer. See, when they receive a manuscript and they have to really wisely think how and whom to choose the referee. And at the same time, because it is very, very crucial for the author, the researcher, who has spent maybe few months or few years in this research, and he's looking for a positive response, or maybe his career is depending upon, you know, very critically on this paper, maybe his PhD degree or postdoc position or some job or position. So it is very crucial for him, especially students, the response of the referee is very, very important. Now, response of the referee, either it may pave a way for improving the scientific publication and then adding a public, good publication to the CV of the author, or it might waste the sheer hard work of many months or years and disappoints or maybe demotivate the researcher, especially the younger ones. So I feel the referee has also a very, very huge responsibility for which actually they should be very, very really committed to the work. This is a kind of commitment towards science and towards improving science and creating an asset, you know, scientific literature for coming generations. So one has to be very, very careful. So yes, I agree with the fact that peer review, it plays a very critical role in scientific scholarly research, and it helps in maintaining the quality of scientific publications. Most of the time, my experience, I have been in research now more than 3 decades, and in all the, I've worked with all eminent scientists and PFR and IUS University. I have experienced various, I've come across various referees, and as a reviewer also, I have seen some papers, and we have various experiences. You know, sometimes many questions and suggestions by the referee, they actually help to enhance the quality of the work. Many reference will point out various errors, like I'm not talking about syntax errors, but the scientific and the conceptual ones. And they push the scientist or the author to think and dig deeper into the concepts, check the correctness of literature survey, results, interpretations, discussions. So overall, they really help to improve the article. And sometimes, Madam said just now, that they give many new ideas to the researcher, and which might help scientists to, you know, it may new perspective or a new way. It makes a difference to their research career. So that's a good contribution of a referee to the student. But these things will only happen if the referee, the peer review, he should be an expert of the subject. And he should bear the attitude of a guru or a mentor or a good teacher who loves doing science and wants to contribute towards the science through this review. So by supporting, he can support the researcher to learn, grow, and actually improve the paper, not just criticizing and making feel bad about his work and just rejecting the paper ruthlessly. So, and secondly, this is a very important thing which we have also faced many times. We've seen it in happening in many various institutions. The referee should not have any biases, prejudices, and judgments towards the researcher. His job is to provide purely scientific review on the content of the paper. And for this, I feel I also agree with the previous panelist that he need not know the author and the affiliation. This should, I would request maybe all the publishers, including Dr. Sushi, that the identity of the author and affiliation should be kept secret. Because that is definitely going to be, there is a bias. When you know other authors are from a very eminent institute or a group, scientific group, then there's always a kind of, you know, favoritism sort of and a bias for the paper. And if it is some unknown young researcher from some unknown, some small city college, then they say, and I have been experienced one of my collaborators. Many papers have been rejected in PRC, a physical review, without a review. The editors only send back the papers. See, this paper is of not a good quality and content, and is not suit the publication in physical review. And the same papers were later on published in Physics Letters B, which is much higher impact factor than the letters. So that biases, they are there. I mean, that's very unfortunate. So there should be some remedy for that, they don't get a chance to have that bias. So they should get only the research content and the paper just to purely look at the scientific content. There cannot be also any sense of superiority, and that makes the researcher feel inferior and consequently demotivates them. So I mean, it has to be a very positive approach. Referee should be willing to appreciate the good part and give constructive criticism to improve the scientific publication, which is very important. And why I'm insisting is because good paper sometimes changes or helps the entire view perspective of a researcher. Especially for the young scholars. And at the same time, the young authors, or maybe all the authors, of course, they should also have a very positive attitude and should see an opportunity to improve the paper in referee criticism. So like when we receive a review report from a paper, and sometimes the referees give wonderful ideas. They will say, okay, why don't you try this? Why don't you do this? And that actually helps to improve the paper, and it really makes the difference. In fact, one of our paper, the referee said, why don't you ask the experimental facilities, the mega projects, that pair and, you know, script and all, if just these nuclei are possible to populate and work experimentally. We never thought of this. So, okay, we wrote to a few people, and then one of them responded, okay, these nuclei can be done experimentally very soon.
Yeah.
So that really strengthened our paper, and then it gave us it for future. So, and then researchers should be willing to dig deeper into the subject and work hard to improve the quality of the paper. I mean, they should not also be disheartened, or they should not feel any humiliation with rejection. They should think of, you know, improving the article. So peer review process, I feel that it should lead to better quality of publication without any biases, without any prejudices, and because we are creating a heritage for science for coming generations. Thank you.
And now, actually, our panelists are from Lucknow and from Karnal and from Mumbai. So geographically, within India, you can understand the point. The same thing, basically, and in a same manner, our views are coming. So first point of the peer review is that the quality of the article, that by the peer review process, actually we get the quality into the article, right? And we check not only the quality, we check the validity of the research methodology, research patterns, and similar things. So, but ultimately, what is the benefit of the peer review process? The benefit of it is that the integrity of science. The main thing, actually, the main purpose of the peer review is that the integrity of science, not like a duplicate or useless article or research information come into the existence, come into the knowledge world. So that is the point, because of peer review process basically is into the existence to stop that fraud or useless information to the scientific community. This is the basic point that we are getting. And the second thing that I had observed and that coming in terms of a single word, that is the biasing. So biasing, actually, if we categorize biasing, so biasing can be categorized according to the researcher individual identity and the gender bias, all right? So I don't know, because right now in our panel, we are equally divided, but I don't know what is the criteria of the reviewer. Right, when they observe the article from a woman scientist or from a man scientist, so does it matter or not? So let's we start from this point, that because every expert person can say that I had observed the biasing, and it happens because this is not a transparent process where one can observe the actual things, that where is the problem in terms of the scientific way to present the research or something else. Right, you mentioned, Dr. Mamta Agarwal ma'am, that when you submit your article first in PRC, they reject it without any peer review process. But again, when you submitted it with some name, it published into the physical review letter. So according to it, actually, and we had also some examples, our own examples, that reviewer, what they do, they just observe the not only the individual identity of the researcher. When I'm saying the individual identity, I'm saying that from where this author belongs, what is the institution, right? Or what is the research career of that person, right? Say that author is male or female. So these things basically matter. So there is no transparency into the peer review process. So first thing, if we have to bring out the transparency into the peer review process, so what do you think that this may be possible way by which one can basically observe the transparency into the peer review process? Ma'am, Professor Poonam, the transparency. There is no transparency into the peer review process. So, one thing I want to add here before I transfer this question to the madam, that when we are discussing about to the reviewer, editor, and the author, all are same. The same person is editor, the same person is one day reviewer, and one day she was the author. So same person, basically at different stage, at different roles. So we have to keep this thing also in our mind, along with, as mentioned, there is a more debate actually on this point, that what should be the peer review process, right? It should be single blind, it should be double blind, or it should be open. And nowadays, if you are aware about to the pub peer website, so there is a possibility of the post-publication. So I want to share this information with all our audience, that don't focus on the pre-publication review process. That give you many more idea, as our panelists share with you, that every good reviewer basically provide you a good insight, good idea about, provided that reviewer is expert in the field, exist in a proper way. So that will help you to bring out the shape of your article, right? So we get the benefit in a genuine way. So my point, first of all, about to the transparency into the peer review process. So how one can bring out the transparency into the peer review process? Ma'am, Poonam Tandon, ma'am. Mike.
I already raised this issue about the transparency in the peer review, and it is very, very true that it is not absolutely a transparent system. Sometimes a paper, if you submit in a journal, maybe in the lower impact factor rejected, and it can be accepted in a paper journal with a much higher impact factor. So like there are issues, and like you said, like if the editor himself is the author, and many times you see, you will find in some journals, you will find many papers from the editorial group, like groups from the members of the editorial board of editor, many publications in the same journal. Okay. And that is why I told you there should be some restriction. If the person is a member of editorial board or editor of the journal, he or she should not be or consider or because, see, he is the person who will appoint the referee. If the person is the member editor or editorial board member, somehow he can easily influence the review process. He is the part of the system, he can influence that. Maybe he can appoint the referees who are known to him and who will give him a favor or things like that. I think there should be some restrictions on the publication from the particular group or like persons who are the member of editorial board or editor of that particular journal. Or there should be some other way out. Maybe the, I don't know what can be the better way of appointing the referees. He can always influence. And second thing is, I already raised this question that if you disclose the name, institution and authors, it will always influence the, it can influence the referee process easily. Generally, if we get some paper for review, first thing is we see that he is the author. We will immediately Google it at how many other publications he has. Okay, what is his background? That is very normal curiosity of a referee to know about the authors, and whether the authors are very well established in that field, then the refereeing becomes easier for a referee. And if he is not so much established, sometimes we have doubts. Okay, it is the first paper he or she has published, maybe two papers only, and we don't know even the age of the author. We don't know the author is 21 year old, and we don't know author is 61 year old. Okay, we see he has published 200 papers, then 201 will also be okay. And he has published or she has published only two papers, it always influences our thought process. So I think the blind review without disclosing the name of author or the institution, all these things, that is a good option for the refereeing. Then the refereeing will be done based on the quality of the research work rather than it will be influenced by the other factor. That is what I would like to say.
So you are in favor of double blind PhD process?
Yeah.
And what is your point of view, Professor Adish Samastra? For the transparency of the PhD process.
Whatever the previous panelist has said, it is okay. But depriving the editorial board is also not good. If they have the meritorious work done and it can be reviewed and published in the same journal, I think it should not be a problem. But only thing is that we should be, you know, honest in every, honesty is the best policy in all respects. And in scientific community also, this is largely influenced by so many factors in terms of identity, etc. It is always there. It is very difficult to stop. I have published in highly, you know, very high impact factor journals, and even they are restricting to provide 6 potential reviewers to review your work, and that too should not be one from one country only. And they ask how you understand, how you know him or her, or you go for some author mapper, this and that, to maintain the transparency. But even then, sometimes. And you will wonder to know, once the paper was accepted, the editor-in-chief asked me, why don't you review some journal articles from our journal and include in the bibliography? I mean, everybody is asking for H-index, I-index, citations, etc. I mean, there are so many grids that we have to fulfill. Okay, so transparency can only be maintained if we follow the ethics. And we truly strictly stick to the scholarship or the merit of the content of the work. That's all. Okay. And it is very difficult because we are all human beings and human nature, everybody knows. It can, we have to control and, you know, our own ways of doing the things. Blind review is okay, but some other kind of reviewing may be having better than this, but some problems may be there in this also. So there is no foolproof system. It is only a way to ensure some sort of quality assurance in the publication. But I have seen many good journals. Some papers are of very inferior quality and the rest of them are really very good. So some kind of lack of transparency or lack of identity problem may be there. So it is difficult, I think. And if you know the person, definitely some impact is going to be there. Okay, so blind review in that way may be good, but depriving the editorial board is not good. I am also editor of some journals. It does not mean that I can't publish in that journal, or I will publish without referring and without doing any that way. Okay. And I think many journals are nowadays disclosing the name of the reviewers also. Okay. And earlier also, maybe 15 years back, there was a tradition in Elsevier journals that after the paper is published, you can request the editor to know the reviewers for some sort of collaboration, etc. And I have no hesitation to tell you the name of the journal also. Applied Soft Computing is a good journal in the field of computing from Elsevier Science. So I think there are ways to maintain the transparency, and the ultimate goal is quality. But we are all human beings. It is really difficult to, I think, go for 100% of anything.
Yeah.
But things are coming up. I think things are improving.
So, Dr. Mamta ma'am, what is your point of view? Because already Dr. Mamta ma'am and Dr. Adish sir have concluded much more. So, do you have something to say about the transparency? in peer review process?
Yes, peer review is very, very important. See, we can referee or an editor. See, if he's dishonest, then we can't help it. So maybe the editors have to be more careful while choosing the referee. I mean, at least the editors should not should have that much integrity that they should not influence the referee. Blind review, I'm in completely agreement, because the referee should not know the authors and the affiliation. Affiliation and authors, it really, really makes a lot of impact on the referee's mind. As Dr. Tandon said, she's a very rightly, she's saying it happens. If I know the authors, and if they are a very new or from some unknown college or some, you know, small college, there will be a bias. And if somebody is a very established, very eminent institute, then obviously there will be some bias towards them. Oh, it will be a good paper only. So, and I have seen that, I have experienced it, because I have worked in TFR and I've collaborated with some very good experimental groups of VECC and SINC. I mean, there are papers, I mean, which are easily acceptable, where I feel it was not such a great work. It was so easily published in physical review. But sometimes very good work is also rejected, that too without review. So these kind of biases are there. So affiliation and the author's name should definitely be kept secret. Yeah. And Dr. Adish, she said at the end you can request later on editors to know the review. So if you know the reviewer, maybe at the end of the review process, it would be nice. So that you know who has reviewed the person. So maybe later on you can discuss some more ideas and maybe you can collaborate, because he's an expert of your field only. So then there is some kind of, you know, some kind of team spirit build-ups by the time the paper is undergoing review. And editors, yeah, they have some responsibility, and it's a commitment that you have to choose the referees very, very wisely. Blind review, I am completely in agreement. Yes, it should be.
Yeah, actually,
that's the idea.
Yeah, because of this reason, actually, world is observing all these facts that we are four people or three people are discussing about the same thing, and same thing is happening around the world. Because of that, this peer review week, the world's publisher and different academic agencies, those who are basically aware, are celebrating this week. And now in India, there are very few of those who are basically active in this way. So professionally, they are doing this thing, but we don't have any institution or a kind of course where we can basically teach our research scholar, young scholars, or the other one, that how to review the article, or what is the process basically. That there is no any kind of, you can say, a formal training for this most responsible job. But here, as Dr. Adesh sir mentioned here, that a reputed journal, and we also are aware about it, that peer review process happen in a better way into the reputed journals. But why the only few article get cited into the reputed journal, rest of remains without citation? So what the reason basically you think, sir? Because you pointed out this thing, that reputed journal basically, and because I am switching this question towards you intensely, because this idea came in my mind when you were discussing something. So in high reputed journals, actually what happens, not all the articles are getting equal citation, or many articles I have personally, and you also observed that, not getting even a single citation. If those articles peer reviewed and published in high reputed journal, what may be the point where do you think that the article or the research work they are not getting even a single citation? So what may be the reason of it? Because we assess the quality of the article from the their citation, the circulation among the society, So, Dr. Adesh, sir, what do you think about it?
Sir, actually, I have some experience. You see, I am working in the field of dairy. My mandate or institute's mandate is dairy. You know, whatever I have to do with computer science, I have to do in the field of dairy. And many people have questioned me that you are a computer engineer and you are a PhD in computing. Yeah. What are you doing in dairy for animal science? So even in Thapar Institute, when I discussed buffaloes, cows and milk, they used to laugh at me. And now they are admiring. You see, computer science is such a versatile field, or science field is such a versatile thing that it can be applicable to anywhere. And animal sciences, animal production is a great, you know, a potential for application of these tools and techniques like artificial. Okay. See, first of all, I will forget otherwise. I have written down, you were telling that the student or the scholar should be, you know, some capacity building should be there for writing good articles. Though there are so many portals and very great many facilities are there online these days. But in NDRE, at least at our institute, we are offering a credit course for technical writing to the PhD students as well as for the PhD students. It's an integral part right from the, maybe I think 30 years I have been seeing it. And going to the library, referring to the library resources, and writing technical articles, papers, etc. It is all taught as a part of their course curriculum. Okay. So I think this is one thing. And what was your second point?
Second point was related to that, that in a very reputed journals, each and every article, goes through the peer review process, but some article not even getting a single citation.
Yeah, I was telling you that suppose you consider Applied Soft Computing Journal or Neural Computing and Application Journal. These are Springer and Altshuler journals, highly means for computer science people, it is high impact factor journals, maybe five or six, not bad. See, when you talk of dairy or when you talk of something uncommon, their reviewers are also actually finding it is difficult to see, it is different thing, why should I disturb and means waste my time. So this type of things are there. You know, sometimes the area of application, if you see neural computing and application journals guidelines, they have seen that the search should be novel, it is good. If you don't have any novelty, the things are old, but the area of application, if you have chosen to be the best and the new one, even then the journal will encourage. Okay, so see, just looking at the field dairy, you are working largely, it is a computer science journal and people are working in the field of computer. Out of 100, maybe 90 people will be on one side and 10 people will be on another side of application side or some uncommon things. So they feel discouraged and they even don't review it. Okay, so selecting the journal for publication of your work is also important, and on both sides, from the author's side as well as on the side of the editorial board, they should also encourage. And I think while reviewing also as a scholar, we should also look at the area of application. Means suppose you are looking into some particular dairy product. For example, one product is their pantoa, it's just like gulab jamun. So we were discussing some engineering properties of this using some artificial tools. Okay. So it was published in, Innovative Food Science and Emerging Technologies Elsevier Journal, a good journal. So see how I selected this particular, journals for publication of this work of my student. You see, because Pantoa is, many times we have to defend. They said that it will be only restricted to a local readership. So you have to defend that Pantoa may be, you know, restricted for a particular group or from an audience, these users, but the techniques and tools are also important that you have used. Okay, so in total perspective, I think the article should be reviewed and it should be cited accordingly. Okay, there is no restriction on the end user to select your paper. Maybe sometimes paper is good, it is a highly impact factor journal article, but its visibility is not proper or whatever. Means today you will see that many journals have now started promoting your work also. Sometimes it is not seen by majority of the people. So Facebook also is there, social media are there, so many things are there. They are encouraging you to share your article on the social media also for its larger or means wider publicity and visibility. So there are so many things being done so that it is ResearchGate is there. They are also creating some sort of impact on your work, published work. By creating some citations, some attractions they do to increase your citations, etc. So there are so many things, but again, it is true that sometimes some papers are getting good citations and some papers are not getting good citations.
So it might be, I personally feel that we are discussing about the peer review process. So it might be that that particular article which are not getting the citation might be because that is not reviewed properly and something somewhere there was a biasing, and because of that, that article published. Because in high reputed journals, what happened, higher level researcher, basically most of them, they follow those journals, right?
In title, some sort of dairy or animal science or some product name, so they will discourage and they will just remove this from their list of review of literature articles. So they will remove it because it is not, they think that they are not related to it. It is not related to them. And I still remember I went to some UGC interview for some Commonwealth program. And they appreciated that this is the only gentleman who has done some job in computing with application to some industry. The rest of them are just having some algorithm and some efficiency of algorithm, theoretical computing. But he has done some, there was a word of appreciation. Okay. So I think we should look into all kinds of possible reviewed literature available. And only which is most relevant should be selected for citations.
Now, the point is towards ma'am, Dr. Poonamchander, ma'am, because you raised this point, connection or networking of the editor or editorial board members, those who review the article actually, because it matters, networking matters. If I am the editor, I have some networking of related people and I will ask to them. Or if I transfer this responsibility to the section editor, then section editor will observe all these things from the their own networking. Right. So now the point is actually this point comes through the diversification into the editorial board. How basically the editor, the journal basically defined the editorial board, what are the diversity, type of the diversity is there, according to the gender, according to the geography, according to the experiences, right? All these things matter. If the editorial board is not diversified on the basis of the gender, on the basis of the experience of the editorial board member, whether they are young scholar or not, so we will also discuss this point of the young scholar, right? We are not providing the opportunity to them, right? But the diversification into the editorial board actually matters. Diversity into the editorial board impact the peer review process. And diversity comes through the age, through the gender, through the experience, through the expertise into the area. All these things basically comes into the diversity, geography, all these things, and culture and individual identity, all these things come into the diversity. When the editorial board is diversified properly, then this kind of problem we don't observe. But when, now I'm sharing this information with you all, my participants, that observe the diversity. That means that from where the editorial board basically exists into that particular journal, what is the gender bias into the gender ratio into the editorial board. So all these things matter when the peer review process basically comes into the existence. So anything related to the diversity of the editorial board member in terms of the age, in terms of the experience, in terms of the culture, in terms of the geography. Dr. Punakandan ma'am, would you like to comment something on it?
Yeah, I think you have raised a very good question and a very good idea. The diversified editorial board may be helpful in the review process, and it may have young persons as well as some senior researchers, as well as like you say, the gender of people from different gender, people from different continents, and that can be helpful for in bringing out transparency in the review process, I feel. But overall, as Professor Adesh said, scientific ethics is the most important. If we don't have scientific ethics, then there is no like way to stop problems in the review. So that is the most important. Like, we have to trust people, we have to trust referee, we have to trust process, and we have to trust each other. But scientific ethics is more important, and it is difficult to put checks and balances on the like scientific ethics. I will say only this one. Yeah.
Thank you. And now the point is related to the that point about to the this has been done about to the diversity into the editorial board, diversity into the when we select the reviewer, and the process of peer review, like whether that is the single blind peer review process or double blind peer review. But I had observed that you mean when you were using blind peer review process, you mean a double blind peer review process. That means neither author nor reviewer knows about to the one each other, right? So now most of the people think, I want to add one sentence here, that for the information, most of the people thinks that the peer review process happens only for the pre-published article. It is not true. Right now, if you see the pub peer website, you will observe the post-publication review also. And pub peer website, pubpeer, pub peer website is the website where people basically review the published article. So you are not free that if your article get published in anywhere. So that's all. There is no this type of thing, because everyone wants equality and integrity into the research, and because of that point, the peer review process is going on. So not only into the peer review process, post review process basically equally important. And now, in addition to the blind peer review process, there is an open peer review process. And exactly, if you type F1000R, then this is a website. Those basically provide the open peer review process, and into the preprint also. All the preprint archive, what they do, they just accept your article and help you to review your article, right? That is preprint review process. So if you want to know more about to the open peer review process, go through the F1000 website. So here you will get the open comments on the submitted article, and there is a process only after that. The article will get published, and the journal basically is indexed into the Scopus also. So nowadays, basically, this kind of approach has been started, that not only the identity of the reviewer, identity of the author had to hide, everything should be clear on the website, right? Journal website, that these are the reviewer comment, these are the answer response of the author. And by this way, the quality basically came into the existence for this published article. So this type of activities has been started, as Professor Adesh Sharma also mentioned, and Dr. Poonam Tandon also mentioned all these things. And now, this one question to the audience, and audience have to write this answer into the comment box, right? So question is for the audience, and question is what? Listen carefully. It I am not writing anywhere. So there will be two, three option of this question. And question is very easy. And this is to just to make aware, alert our target audience. Right now they are 66, right, or 55, right? I hope some of them will be busy and some will be involved here. So the question of this panel discussion is, first question is, when does peer review typically occur? The question is for the target audience, our audience, is when does peer review typically occur? Option one, prior to publication. B, in parallel with the publication process. C, post publications. So these three are options of this question. I am repeating again the question, when does peer review typically occur? Option one, prior to publication. Second option, in parallel with the publication process. Number three, and post publications. And these are three options of this question. So you have to just type the right answer in your chat box, right? Or you can comment it. And there are actually some elements are assumed. Assessed by peer review process, that is the credibility, as we had discussed, and relevance of the work in relation to the publisher's scope and research method and accuracy, originality and significance of the work. So these are four major main points that the reviewer basically observe in your article. And an open question to all, that where does a peer reviewer's job end? Question is, where does a peer reviewer's job end? Option are, number one, with publication. Number two, with the completion of review. Number three, with the acceptance decision. Repeating the question again, where does a peer reviewer's job end? Number one, with publication. Number two, with the completion of review. Number three, with the acceptance decision, right? You can comment your response here, right? And now the point is, we were discussing that about to the peer review process and some facts related to the peer review process. Now the point is, where is the problem into the peer review process? Actually, when the author publish the article, they get citation, they get research project on the basis of the published article. Editor get the reputation of the journal, publisher also get the reputation of the journal. But what the reviewers get from the review after this peer review process? You got my question? My question is to all the panelists, the author basically when published the article, getting the credit in terms of the promotion, in terms of the job, in terms of the research project, and get the identity itself, being a researcher, right? And on the other hand, journal, whether that is related to the editor or publisher, they are also getting the importance of their journal in terms of the citation, in terms of the reputation. But what the reviewers are getting after involving so much time and effort? Dr. Mamta Agarwal, ma'am, first of all, you just gave the response. What do you think about it? You had spent actually, in general, when you review the article, you spent at least 1 week on that. Right? First of all, you will read, then after you will observe the other references and other article, and then you will comment on that particular thing.
Yeah, this is a very, very relevant question. I mean, in fact, nobody has ever asked and thought about it. But yeah, it's very natural to think that everybody gets something out of this. But the referee who has actually, we are expecting so much from him that he should give a very scientific and unbiased and very good review. What does he get? I don't think, I mean, it, other than some sort of academic satisfaction or maybe academic, I don't know if a reviewer gets some academic credentials if you are a reviewer of certain papers. Maybe other than that, it does not add to anything to his career or his, you know, in terms of achievements, maybe some kind of academic satisfaction. But other than that, it's a lot of hard work on him. So I also feel when he expects integrity and very very critical and, you know, very committed review from him, he should also be rewarded for something. I mean, I don't know in what form, but that has to be there.
Yeah. And,
another fun point I wanted to say, Dr. Adesh. Okay.
Professor Adesh, sir. Professor Poonam, ma'am, your response in terms of this question that what the credit basically has to be given to the reviewer after investing so much time. So, if they are not available, right, I am just sharing one information with you all. Whether you review your work or someone, and so where basically you can get the credits of it. Publons is the website where, as Poonam Tandon mentioned here in the beginning. So on that website, you just can include your all the reviews article, your all the journal information. So create a Publon profile and include there. Create a ORC ID and mention that into. So nowadays, basically, this thing is on priority set so that the reviewer basically get the credit and make their own identity into the research community, similar way as the author getting the credit and on the other hand, the publisher. So create your ORC ID and create your Publons profile, and on these two platforms, basically, you can update all the information, whether you review the normal journal article or a reputed article, if provided the journal information is available on that particular platform. So this Publon is very important nowadays and at this time. So now next point that I was thinking to discuss in a brief way, sometimes what happened that a senior professor, when reviewed the article, they sometimes get biased and put very, very critical comments to the author. And because of that, authors get discouraged and sometimes they don't follow the same research work or they switch the research work. So how basically the reviewers have to maintain the comment if they are providing critical comment to any research work? Professor Adesh,
can you repeat the question, please? I was just
okay. All right. The question actually, first, the point was I had mentioned that in general, a reviewer doesn't get the credit in the same way as the author and the publisher, right? Author basically, when publish the article, they get some reputation into the institution, they get some grants, they get some citation. On the other hand, publisher basically get the reputation of the journal, right? What type of credit basically, or what gain basically, what type of gain this reviewer basically takes from this type of process?
Sir, as I told you, honesty is important. Ethics is important. Yeah. Similarly, you know, selfless work is also important in science. Okay. Hmm. Number two, if we think directly, we may not be benefited, but indirectly, it is enormously benefited. The reviewer, first of all, has the opportunity to read so many good things which are new and he may not be knowing, frankly speaking. Okay, let me tell you my case. Once a paper came to me to review something. Okay, so that type of work was very new to me. and it opened some avenues for me to work in that area and excel, which has in long run contributed to my profile a lot, which I have benefited from a lot. Okay, momentary gain, maybe it is not there. So, or some sort of monetary gain may not be there. I mean, some remuneration co-op, honorarium may not be there, and we are not working for that. Okay, but you have linkage developed with some good people, some good universities, institutions abroad also. Okay. So I think benefit is really enormous, and a great impact you get. Yeah. I may not be able to enumerate all the points in terms of means quantified benefits, but really, and you also, in our institution, in our organization, there is a column like, you know, some sort of marks are or scores are weightages assigned to this scientific work outside the institution, maybe within country or abroad, wherever you have contributed to the scientific community, some weightage is given. So if you see some organizations or some, maybe due to some UGC, mujhe malum nahi hai, kyunki I am not directly working under UGC, but UGC University to hai NDRI, we are getting funds from central government. Okay, directly. But UGC might have also earmarked some benefit to the professors or so, review, I mean, those who are involved in reviewing process in terms of their promotion benefits, etc. So I think we should not think in that narrow way. And keeping in touch with the scientific community at large is also the greatest, biggest, you know, benefit that we can get. So I love it.
I add this question because nowadays this this type of idea and this thing basically is on priority. So Pabloon and ORC ID basically are providing this kind of benefit to the reviewers. So they link up their review work at their platform. So they can basically create their own identity as a reviewer.
Reputation or sort of academic reputation.
Yes.
Visibility of the professor, visibility of
Right.
Lab even.
And now, sir, we are at the end of our session, and here the most important question is related to the early career researchers. So how basically they learn about the peer review process? I know that Pabloons is the website. Not only you will get here all the profile development related to the research review as an author or editor like that, you will also learn many things about to the peer review process. And there is a course of the Pabloons. But in India, most of the time when personally being an editor and journal manager, when we approach to someone and get the feedback of the peer review process, what they mention, sir, they just mentioned that the article formatting instead of the research work, they just mentioned that this line is not written properly, the language is not proper, and they don't focus on the quality of the research work. They just focus on the formatting and they just focus on the language. This is not the peer review part, right? So what do you think, and how basically you will suggest that early career researcher basically get trained in a proper way? And how basically you are contributing in this direction?
So you want me to answer this question?
Yes, sir.
I think in young age, you have a lot of energy.
Right.
Okay. But you have to, you know, direct this energy towards a particular focused point. And it needs passion.
Right.
Okay. Passion is very important. If you do not have passion and only you are working for some greeds to fulfill, but I think in research it is not possible. You should have a passion to go for something.
Right.
As I had and I have, and I don't claim myself as a professor. I always tell to my students that I am a learner. And it is visible from my acts in my institution and those who know me, including you, that I would like to sit with M.Tech students and learn something from them, like Python, R. In my time, it was Fortran. Okay, so I know Python, I know R, I know computer vision. Why and how? Because I am working with the students, students are working with me, we are interacting with each other. And I think youngest people should try to learn from their elders, and they should have an adaptive nature. They should adapt. If I am sitting in the dean's room, some slogan is, mounted on some wall. So I would like to see, I picked up a word adapt. I was aware only of adapt. I was aware of the word adopt. I was not aware of the word adapt. You see, this is my observation.
Okay.
Scientist should be a good observer also. And those observations you should be able to convert into ideas. And ideas you have to implement through your tools and techniques. You are, conversant with it. Or you have to gain the skills to work on it. ठीक है हमारे यहाँ एक स्लोगन लगा हुआ था हिंदी में था पता नहीं कितने लोगों को समझ में आएगा जिसे लगन होती है उसे साधन मिल जाते हैं और अगर उसे साधन नहीं मिलते तो उनका निर्माण कर लेता है उसके नीचे लिखने वाले का नाम भी था जो मैं भूल गया हूँ तो पैशन बहुत जरूरी है और एक है कि देखो हम लोग जैसे आजकल प्लीज डोंट माइंड प्रीडेटरी जर्नल्स जो से आजकल एक वर्ड निकला हुआ है प्रीडेटरी जर्नल्स उसमें क्या है कि आज आप पैसे क्रेडिट कीजिए उनके खाते में सुबह तक पेपर ऑनलाइन हो जाएगा ठीक है और वो आपकी जो जॉब प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स हैं या जॉब फुलफिलमेंट्स हैं वो सारी उसके साथ आप उसको करके दिखा के अपना बेनिफिट ले सकते हो बट इट इज ग्रेटली डैमेजिंग द यू नो साइंटिफिक फैब्रिक ऑफ द कंट्री एज वेल एज ऑफ द ग्लोब वो शॉर्टकट्स नहीं चलेंगे इसमें शॉर्टकट अपने को नहीं लेना है मेरे प्रोफेसर ने आगे मुझे बोला कि ये अप्लाइड सॉफ्ट कंप्यूटिंग में जाना है मैं डिफेंस देख के आया हूँ स्टूडेंट का तुम्हें भी यही करना है तो आई फ्रेंकली टोल्ड हिम सर आई एम इन सर्विस कैंडिडेट ये जितने भी आपकी एस्पायरेशन है अरमान है किसी और स्टूडेंट से पूरे कर लेना मेरे तो विदाउट पे हो जाऊंगा मैं मींस माय मींस वे ऑफ थिंकिंग वाज लाइक दिस ही सेड नथिंग डूइंग नाउ यू विल डू इट इन दिस जर्नल ओनली दो गाइड थे दूसरा बोला कि जी मैंने बोला कि जी ये काम करना है नहीं नहीं हम इंटरनेशनल जर्नल में भेजते हैं इंटरनेशनल का मतलब ये नहीं है कि हिंदुस्तान ये पाकिस्तान और बर्मा और ये बांग्लादेश वाला जर्नल हो कहीं तुम उनको जानते हो तुम्हें जानते हो एक दूसरे के साथ करते रहो इट शुड बी ट्रूली इंटरनेशनल और साइंस सिटेशन इंडेक्सिंग में इसका नाम आना चाहिए सो ये क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्ड इसीलिए बनाए गए हैं कि ताकि और इसका इट्स डिविडेंड्स आर ऑब्जर्व्ड इन द लॉन्ग रन व्हेन आई पब्लिश्ड एज अ पीएचडी वर्क इट वॉज अ पायनियर वर्क इन द कंट्री एंड इट वॉज ओनली आई थिंक सेवंथ वॉल्यूम ऑफ दैट जर्नल And impact factor was less than 2 or dead था एक था कुछ इतना होगा आज वो 7 है so you get the award and rewards in the long run at the young age when you do something it will be useful at a age of maybe after 10 years you will realize its importance so in the passion if you have a passion and a strict you know shortcut नहीं करना है बिल्कुल भी तो आपका जो साइंटिफिक वर्क है रिक्वायरमेंट क्या नीड बेस्ड होना चाहिए टू सॉल्व सम प्रॉब्लम जैसे फार्मर का प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करना है इट इज नॉट ओनली टू जस्ट पब्लिश एंड गेट ए नंबर टू फुलफिल सम जॉब प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स दैट इज आल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट बट साइड वाइज इट शुड ट्राई टू सॉल्व ए स्मॉल प्रॉब्लम मे बी वॉट एवर इट इज ओके तो फंडामेंटल रिसर्च विद सम एप्लीकेशन इन ए नॉवल एरिया is really a great contribution and slowly slowly you will find its importance and its impact also
yeah sir actually what the people are doing they are just focusing on one small problem and publishing 3-4 articles on that basically in a scientific terms known as slamming slicing so that kind of problem has been generated among our scientific society and people are basically facing the problem because of that culture. So it is our duty that we a kind of awareness society go about to the scientific publication, about to the scientific activity we provide. So Dr. Mamta Agarwal ma'am, at the end, what kya aapka conclusion rahega? And any message to this audience?
Dr. Sushil, there are a few points I would like to mention after all the discussion. I was very impressed with Dr. Adesh. He said because his work is something, you know, not a very, very uncommon work, and he has adopted, he has taken up that, adapted, not adopted. And that's very nice. So our younger generation should be encouraged to go for application-based sciences, which is really useful to society. Now, for that, one, we as scientists and maybe in education and research, who are active researchers and educationists, we should create a scientific, we have to help, we have to start some program to, you know, build up a scientific temperament among youngsters, which I'm seriously, I mean, I'm starting that and I'm doing that, that we should whenever a student comes for PhD, that time he is actually trained for research, and then only first time he writes a paper. No, so, but that's very late. By the time he comes to PhD, he should be trained for, you know, in writing a paper, in, you know, all the research ethics. They should be inculcated in him during the education process, maybe in the BSc and MSc. So yeah. Right from BSc, a student should be encouraged to interact with scientists, scientific community. See, they are working in isolation. The bigger institutes, scientific institutions are working separately. They have no connection with the normal common colleges and other students. Students, mm-hmm. don't even know that there are such big, huge mega projects are going on in the country, and our scientists are working for them. So there has to be some awareness. There has to be some training to the student, young students, right from the, you know, BSc first year, or maybe from school level, that they should be at least aware of their, you know, research activities happening, research career opportunities also. We have to create opportunities as well as we have to make them aware of the opportunities. Thirdly, we have to create a scientific writing is very, very important. See, many students do very good work, but their English or their language, they're not very good at writing. And many times we have observed that many referees, you know, they just detect, oh, paper is very badly written. I don't even understand what are you writing. What are you trying to say? This work seems interesting, but I don't know. I mean, please consult some. So they find it very difficult because they don't know any eminent scientists or, you know. So there are science writers, you know, there has to be a kindly complete ecosystem which has scientific writers. Which who can help students in writing and, you know, editing the journals, the papers. So before going to submitting a journal to a publisher, maybe our ecosystem should help a student to write or maybe have a very good article. So that from India, from at least I feel from India, from my country, whenever a paper is published to some international journal or some measure, it should be of good quality. So that our ecosystem has to ensure, which is the agenda in my mind. I mean, I really want to do this. And I'm sure everybody in the panel maybe would like to work towards this kind of, you know, that from BSc, we have to train them for research. And in one thing I wanted to say that you said editors level, we should diversify. I feel that there should be some editors who assign referees. Maybe they need not be a researcher. Maybe we can appoint some writers or some, you know, people who know science, but, you know, they need not be researchers, active researchers, so that there is no competitiveness or that there is no bias. So maybe we can have some hire some managers or some different field people also who know science but not actively necessarily researchers. So that will also help to, you know, so that a scientist should do scientist work. A scientist should be a scientist. We should not make him an administrator. So that kind of, demarcation lines we have to draw somewhere. So that will reduce biases to an extent. Of course, we cannot ensure anybody's honesty. But yeah, as an editor, since you're an editor and you're working with a publishing group, I think maybe there can be some guidelines for a reviewer. Like you were saying that some referees, they just give some formatting mistakes and syntax errors. This is not written properly. That figure is not good. So there should be some guidelines maybe given to them that they have to fill up, you know, they have to fulfill all those requirements for being a referee. So a choice of referee is very important. And of course, this contribution is very important. But as an ecosystem, being scientists and teachers, our contribution to science what we have to really seriously think about. And we have to start working on it. Since because everything has started online, we are now, so the traveling and all those hassles are also, one can interact with anyone. anywhere you can reach. So reaching out is very easy. So I think now we should reach out to maximum number of students and train them for, to be a good researcher.
Yeah, perfectly fine. And this kind of information actually make aware the scholars. So as you had also mentioned, to train the young scholar during the BSc, MSc, and PhD time. Actually, PhD time, mentor researcher basically train the student to write the articles only, and how to write in a better way, how to publish in a good journals. But very few people basically are here, those who train their research in terms of the peer review process. So, but it happens in general when they comes into the senior stage, mentors show them their referee comments, and then after most of the time, but what happened, they give the response on their side. But this type of exercise should start from the beginning during the PhD time, that all the response basically by given to the author, by the early career researchers in their writing the article. And there is a very urgent need to train the researcher about to the peer review process, because you can imagine now drastically number of number of articles has been submitted, but very few people are there who can review the article. So there is a big demand of the reviewers in the market, you can say. And but they are not effectively trained for that purpose. So to bring out the quality, to bring out the integrity into the science of that particular research area. And because of that reason, this kind of predatory journal or predatory publications has been increased drastically, because people are not aware about to the peer review process, how they are very well known about to their subject, about to the research work, but they are not effectively not trained by the that peer review process. So that is the demand. And I hope Professor Poonam Tandon ma'am had left because of some reason. She is dean and the activity involved into the university. So there is no problem, sir. Your concluding remark already been included, or would you like to share something more? This, sir?
Dr. Sushil.
Yes, sir.
I would like to add to whatever I have said. मेरे दिमाग से भूल जाता हूँ मैं जल्दी जल्दी ना
ये सभी अच्छे जो साइंटिस्ट हैं उनके साथ में रहता है
इधर लगा दी कहने में इतने में मैं ड्रॉप
तो मेरा जो कंक्लूजन चल रहा था ट्रेनिंग फॉर द पीयर रिव्यू प्रोसेस बिकॉज यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग ट्रेनिंग टू द राइटिंग रिसर्च आर्टिकल राइटिंग और मेनी अदर थिंग्स बेसिकली नाउएडेज गोइंग ऑन लाइक पब्लिकेशंस एंड हाउ टू avoid predatory art journals. There are so many kind of exercises are going on. So we, so my purpose to ask you that would you like to comment something or any concluding remarks about the peer review or this kind of exercise? Because my purpose to organize this panel to bring out some points among the scientific community, and I know actually in the interior there are very many researchers, those who are not aware about to the good journals and good practices. So
yes. It came to my mind, sir. Please don't mind, I am interrupting.
No. I am speaking because I want that you just recall your point.
Right. So you see, you were talking of something, training everything to the students. Yes. Training everything. Yes. To the, you know, self-learning. At the end of my, you know, career, maybe 35 years I have spent in this area, I have concluded in my life that self-learning is the best way of learning. If you do not have, you know, an instinct of self-learning, probably whatsoever or whosoever best teacher aapko padha raha hai, wo mere khayal se aap tak nahi pahunch payega jab tak ki aap itne receptive hain. मैंने कहा ना आपको कि बोर्ड भी कोई टंगा हुआ है दीवार पे तो जाते हुए देखता हुआ जाता हूं, कहीं देख लिया मैंने वर्ड पढ़ लिया पेंडुला, अब पेंडुलम का पेंडुला होता है ना, अब ऐसे और कितने वर्ड्स हैं बस में बैठा जा रहा हूँ कुछ नहीं कर सकता, तो अपने माइंड में सोचता हुआ जा रहा हूँ कि ऐसे कितने वर्ड्स हैं जो पेंडुलम को पेंडुला के तरीके से होगा, ठीक है ना, तो वो जब तक मैं उतरा हूँ डेस्टिनेशन पे जाके आई कुड हैव रिकॉल्ड मे बी टू डजन ऑफ द वर्ड्स दैट वर देयर इन माय माइंड. सो वी शुड बी अडैप्टिव, पैशनेट एंड फोकस्ड एंड हाईली सेल्फ लर्निंग. ओनली टिप ऑफ द आइसबर्ग टीचर कैन गिव यू और द ट्रेनर्स कैन गिव यू, मेंटर्स कैन गिव यू. मुझे भी गाइड ने बोला कि एक इसमें फंडामेंटल रिसर्च का कंपोनेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव में जरूरी है. तुम ऐसा करो, एक तुम्हारे वो आईआरबी में भी बोला गया था कि भी ये जो आप न्यूरल नेटवर्क बना रहे हो उसमें रैंडम इनिशियलाइजेशन ना हो करके एक डिटर्मिनिस्टिक होना चाहिए, तो तुम एक इसके अंदर डिटर्मिनिस्टिक करो. दिस इज द आइडिया ही हैज गिवन. बोलो आगे कि आगे कैसे करूं सर इसको, कि आप इस तरीके से कर लो, ये वाला टेक्निक यूज कर लो, क्यूबिक स्प्लाइन इंटरपोलेशन टेक्निक यूज कर लो. दिस इज ही टोल्ड मी एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर माइंड. तीन किताबें लेकर के गया हूं मैं लाइब्रेरी से, प्रोफेसर को समझ में नहीं आ रहा इस फील्ड में मुझे तो कोई क्यूबिक स्प्लाइन इंटरपोलेशन क्या है, कैसे है, मैंने तो क्या बात, कोई इसके ऊपर लिटरेचर वगैरह अवेलेबल नहीं है कोई. ही वाज वेरी काम एंड कूल एंड वेरी यू नो सोबर फेलो, बड़े आराम से पूछते थे और मेरे से थोड़े छोटे भी थे एज में एक आध साल, तो इसलिए भी जरा ज्यादा वो करते थे. तो मैंने उनसे कहा कि साहब मैं ये ये क्या लेके घूम रहे हो, मैं कह ये तीन बुक्स हैं लाइब्रेरी से कुछ लेके आया हूँ मैं उस पे ऑप्टिमाइजेशन पे, उसमें कुछ है ये. अरे तीन किताबें तुम लिए घूम रहे हो और फिर कह रहे हो तुम्हें पता नहीं चल रहा, इसका मतलब तुम करना नहीं चाहते, भाग जाओ यहाँ से एक हफ्ते के बाद आना. एंड आई कुड डेवलप द प्रोग्राम, आई कुड राइट एवरीथिंग एंड मैंने उनको जाके बोला और ऑब्जेक्टिव क्लियर हो गया, इसका मैंने कर लिया है एंड आई नो हाउ टू डू इट. So he knew the potential of the student. Student should be adaptive and he should be vibrant. Learn karna chahiye. Self learning is the best way of. He will only give you the idea. Agar aap bologe ki sare PhD Guruji karwa denge, to fir main kya karunga? Hai na? So student jo young age mein hai, they should be absolutely energetic and they should you know manage their energy in a fruitful way. Self learning is the most crux of the things.
Yeah, and this should be a mantra, because I was up to the 2012 a regular researcher, and then we had switched into the publication and we had learned number of the things about the publication, and we are carrying now different journals and different activities and learning behind the curtain what basically goes behind the curtain. So there are many things that regular researcher or traditional researcher cannot understand that publication research. But we will discuss all these things next time, and I have taken enough time to of you, and so now in the conclusion we were just discussing about the peer review identity in peer review, because this is the peer review week, and we are celebrating because just to make aware about to the people, this is non-traditional approach. In general, people basically organize the seminar event for the traditional things like related to the research, related to the some kind of academic activities. But this is also a activity, but very few people are basically involved. So, but very important in research area. So, in general. We had come on conclusion that peer review is basically designed to assess the validity, quality, and the originality of the article for publication. And ultimately, the purpose is to maintain the integrity of science by filtering out invalid or poor quality articles. We have to avoid the predatory journals and that kind of exercises. There are some rule their point about to the peer about to the predatory journals and publishers, so we have to check that carefully. And now the peer review are of different type. We understand single blind peer review, double blind, and pre-publication peer review and post-publication review, transparent peer review from the open peer review process, so we are aware. So, sir, thank you so much for your time and giving some more useful information. And Dr. Pankaj Agarwal, thank you so much. And I'm thankful to the Professor Poonam Tandon ma'am for giving us time, because we had put up to the 70 minutes and now more than that. So thankful to the audience. If you are available here and would like to ask any question, you're most welcome. Or you people can email me, because we are now and tomorrow and next day we are discussing about to the tomorrow, sir, we are discussing about to the proofreading into the research article and the technical points related to that. Next day we will discuss some more point about to the identity. So there is a very packed program of our regular activity I will share with you all. And at the end, again, thankful to all of you, those who gave time and tried to understand all the things that we had shared. And if you would like to share anything from your side and want to put anything, you can share on my email ID. I would basically try to give you a certificate of this event to all the participants. So thank you once again. Thank you so much. And sir, ma'am, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you to all the panelists, all the audience.
Thank you very much to all the panelists and to all the audience. And to students, yes, sir, students should be, very dedication is necessary for research. So those who are want to pursue research in science, they should be ready for very committed work towards science.
And tomorrow we will be again at 12 o'clock. Next day again 12 o'clock. So thank you. We'll meet again. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, ma'am. Bye. Thank you. So I am leaving right now. If you are there and would like to ask anything, so you can write a message.